Hello everyone, Arlesen85 here, and welcome back to the Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time playthrough, or let's play. You may be wondering why it's nighttime. When the last video ended, it was daytime. But basically, that was my first session. I went ahead and saved at that point. And when you save, you don't actually restart right back. Let's get this hidden gold scatula that was up in the tree. But when you restart, reload a save, you don't start exactly where you saved. As a child, you start back in your home, which was in the forest at the beginning of the game. So I just had to run back over here. And it's actually better off because at nighttime, there's some things we have to do at nighttime here anyway. So it works out for the best. So let's go ahead and head in here. And we're going to go into the graveyard. Alright, let's see if we can get some rubies, because in the graveyard, you've seen that guy that was walking real slow, the gravekeeper. His name is Dampy, and he has a mini-game here, which is kind of tedious, actually, and can take quite a while sometimes. You see these soft soil spots? Basically, for 10 rubies, he would dig up the soft soil spot, and it depends. Sometimes there's nothing in it. Sometimes you can get up to 20 rubies out of it, I believe. And basically what you want to get out of it is a heart piece. And 10 rubies each try, you can only hold 99 rubies. And I think there's a total of 10 or 12 soil spots. So you obviously are going to need more rubies. And on top of that, each soil spot can be dug up twice. So yeah, this can be pretty tedious, especially when he walks so slow. But basically, we're going to try for a couple minutes. If it doesn't, if I don't get the heart piece right away, or I need to go get more rubies or something, I'll just edit it out and cut it all out until I do get the heart piece. But I'm going to show you a few of them just so you can get the idea of what I'm doing. So yes, we want you to dig here. All right, see, nothing there at all. So now you just got to get him to come up to the next soil spot, and you can see he walks so slow. It's a big circle. You got to stop him right as he's in front of the soil spot that you want him to dig. And we got nothing again. Like I said, each spot you can dig on it twice. Like sometimes there could be like a 1 ruby in there, and then if you have him dig it again, there could be a 20 ruby in there, or a heart piece. But basically, instead of digging it twice, I just let him go all the way around it twice. I'm gonna try this whole walkway here, and then I'll just cut it out. I let him get passed away, so on this one, probably won't get nothing out of this one either. Wow, that's pretty sad. Let's see. It's very, very tedious and kind of irritating, also. Come on, heart piece. Ah, single ruby. Let's go ahead and have him dig in this hole again. See what happens. Nothing. Alright, I didn't say every time, but sometimes there is double prizes within the same hole. So there's actually a gold scatula up here, which we can't do nothing about yet, so we'll have to come back here later anyway. But I'm gonna go ahead and dig these last two spots right here, and then I'll just go ahead and not really speed it up, but just edit it out until I do find the heart piece, if I don't find it. Because I'm not having any luck right now. And I know you guys don't want to sit here waiting for this slow-ass grave digger to come over here while I get a heart piece. I will show me getting it, though, so don't worry about that. You're not going to miss anything except for me going to get more rubies, or me going to get having him going around and digging every single spot. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and cut it out. Now I'm going to go ahead and start to edit it, and yeah, I'll meet you guys back as soon as I find the heart piece. And there we go. Didn't take too long to get it. Let's get it now, though. Didn't take that long to get it, honestly. I just had to go and fill up my wallet with rubies. Just one time, so it wasn't that bad. And I still have 60 rubies left. Yeah, it wasn't that bad, so. Now that we're back, we're gonna come back here to the royal family tombstone and whip out our ocarina and let's see if I can do this. There we go. I just wish you could use the N64 controller on the Wii. That would make things so much easier. I would pull out the N64. It's in the back of the attic. And actually play it on the original cartridge and everything. But I'm using component right now, so I'm recording this with my HD PVR. So the Wii only goes. I mean, the N64 you obviously can't do that with. So that's only a composite cable. I'm using a component for this, so it makes it look a little bit better. So yeah, let's go ahead and drop down on the new the grave, the royal family's tomb. All right, looks like we got some keys. And yes, they're called keys, not bats. So here, let's see. All right. Let's take all them out, and I believe there's one over here. Here we go. Give me my rubies. I deserve them. After all that with the Dampy's minigame, that was kind of annoying. Alright. And now we have a new enemy here that you don't want to get close to, because when they scream, you can't move, and then they jump on you, see? And then they just jump on you and suck the life out of you. Alright, let's go ahead and read this inscription on the wall. The rising sun will eventually set. A newborn's life will fade. From sun to moon, moon to sun, give peaceful rest to the living dead. This is an interesting poem, huh? Something is inscribed on the tombstone. It's the secret melody of the composer brothers. The Sun Song. And basically what the Sun Song does, like certain things you can only do at day, and certain things you can only do at night. Like that Dampy, the graveyard minigame we just did, you can only do that at nighttime. And there's a cuckoo mini game where you get a empty bottle. You can only do that in the daytime. So there's certain things. And there's chests that appear when you play the Sun Song. And actually, I'll show you right now, it freezes the re-deads. And then it freezes them, and you don't have to worry about them. You can kill them, but I just run past them. I don't even usually worry about killing them. It's no big deal to me. I think two jump attacks takes them out. Maybe two jump attacks and one regular sword slash, so 5 hit points maybe. I can't remember. It's not that big of a deal. All right, now we can go ahead over here. Oh yeah, we got to play the Sun Song again because the child is pretending to be Dampy, and he doesn't want us messing with the gravestone, so let's go ahead and do that. Okay, now we can go ahead and move the gravestones. Some of them are secret, some of them have ghosts inside of them, so you don't want to pull up the wrong ones. Alright, now we get to kill this re-dead. Let's go ahead and do the Sun Song again. You gotta get used to that, because we're gonna be playing that song quite a bit. Alright. Okay, it was a lot more hits than I said it was. Alright, now that he's dead, we can actually play the Sun Song again. And like I said earlier, it makes sometimes a chest to appear. Let's see what we got. Sweet, another heart piece. So far you've collected two pieces. With two more you will gain another heart. So we will have five hearts after we collect two more heart pieces. Alright, and there's one more thing we can do in this graveyard at this time. We will be coming back here later though. You see this one right here has flowers in front of it, so let's go ahead and check that out. Oh, it's a secret. What do you know? Like, I didn't know it was a secret. And I believe, we get the Hylian shield. We're gonna need that. And here's a bombable wall. I can't remember what's behind it. I think it's just a fairy's fountain or something like that. I normally don't come back to it because I think that's all it is. Alright, now we can go ahead and leave this graveyard for now. Go ahead and try to see if we can get our ammo back for our slingshot that we lost for some reason. There we go. Oh yeah, we used them on the keys.